Donald Trump is the presumptive GOP nominee for president after a near sweep on Super Tuesday. But when his last major opponent standing, Nikki Haley, dropped out this week, she didn't throw her support behind Trump. Despite calling on Haley voters to support him, Trump made clear he doesn't want anyone critical of him in the party.
The greatest movement in the history of our country. And they say, always trying to demean, well, MAGA really represents 48% of the Republican Party. No, it represents 96% and maybe 100%. We're getting rid of the Romneys of the world. We want to get Romneys and those out.
Exit polls tell a slightly different story. A third of Republican primary voters in North Carolina and Virginia said they would not vote Republican in November, regardless of the nominee. Tuesday's elections did more than just decide the Republican nomination. They reflected a deep schism in the party, dividing some lifelong Republicans from Trump's MAGA faction. To discuss this, I'm joined today by two Republicans, former Congressman Denver Riggleman from Virginia and strategist Barrett Marson, who's based in Phoenix. Denver and Barrett, thank you so much for joining. Denver, I want to start with you. Senate Minority Leader Mitch McConnell endorsed Trump within 24 hours after his Super Tuesday wins. That's the same man, Mitch McConnell, who called Trump morally and practically responsible for the January 6th insurrection. Does McConnell's attempt at unity reflect the reality for voters?
Yeah, I think it does. You know, I mean, if you look at McConnell, I mean, it's no different than what McCarthy did after January 6th when he rolled over and showed his belly and went to Mar-a-Lago after he blamed Trump for January 6th. You see all these individuals coming home. And I think a lot of that has to do with what I call liege politics. It's like my liege, I will do what thou will hast me do, you know, something like that. It's just absolutely unbelievable to me. But again, what did Trump get? About 75% of the vote. I know a lot of people said there were individuals that would not vote for Trump and things of that nature. But most people do come home. I remember in my little convention in a church, you know, everybody saying, Denver will never, you know, vote for this guy. He's awful. But they did.
Barrett, Denver says that Republicans will come home, but a majority of Haley voters in both North Carolina and Virginia said that if Trump is convicted of a crime, that he's unfit to be president. As a lifelong Republican yourself, do you think that the former president is unfit for office?
You know, it's going to be up to voters to decide whether Trump is unfit, but he is certainly wrong, and he's wrong for this time. There is no doubt Nikki Haley would trounce Joe Biden, certainly in Arizona. It would not be a competitive state. But because Donald Trump and all his many faults are going to be presented to us, voters here in Arizona and across the country, it's going to be a very competitive race because of that.
Barrett, why do you think that he's wrong?
Well, look, he has got so many faults. If not for January 6th, certainly this campaign and most of his time in out of office has shown he is much more interested in settling scores and going after his political enemies than actually doing anything. And I don't think that's where most Americans are. I think they want a much a rosier outlook on life. They don't want grievance politics. And that's truly what Trump is all about for the last, you know, four, 3.5 years while he's been out of office.
Denver, I'd like to drill down a little bit to the state results in Super Tuesday contest. In Texas specifically, GOP Congressman Tony Gonzalez is facing a runoff now from the right. Because of the fact that he was supportive of bipartisan gun safety legislation, he was supportive of gay marriage. What do you think? I mean, he may still very well win that contest in the general, but what's your takeaway from that?
Well, you know what happened to me when I officiated a same-sex wedding, Laura. I got censured, you know, by the local Republican Party. So it wasn't great, you know, winning bipartisan gun legislation, the fact that I was pro-immigration for H-2As, we're in a rural agricultural district, that pretty much got me drummed out, and the Republican Party ran away from me in this district as fast as they could, you know, based on those topics, which seemed to be moderate and sane. I think when you heard Trump talking about pushing out everybody that's like Romney, that's really pushing out people like me, too. You're talking about the moderate and the sane. People try to compromise, really what the Constitution was all about when the founders set up, you know, this incredible experiment that we have in the United States of America. I think what we have is the sane and the moderate are being run out of the party. it's either Trump, you know, his way, or it's the highway.
I want to echo something that Denver said. You know, elections are about bringing in the biggest amount of voters you can get, the most amount of people, the biggest tent. And continually we hear from Donald Trump and people like Carrie Lake that they don't want moderate Republicans to vote for them. They, you know, want to excise them from the party. Well, you know, they are without a home. Those voters like myself in Denver are sort of without a home. So it's either don't vote for Trump and don't vote for Biden, or maybe cast your vote for Biden because at least he wants my vote.
Barrett, speaking of Carrie Lake, Senator Kristen Sinema said that she is not going to run for re-election in your home state of Arizona. And establishment Republican figures like Senator John Thune have thrown their support behind Carrie Lake, who's running in the Republican primary for that Senate seat. How would you compare, you know, Carrie Lake is an election denier, and she's was considered a more extreme candidate in 2022. How would you compare the state's Republican Party in Arizona to the larger Republican Party?
Well, look, there is absolutely no doubt we are a MAGA base. Carrie Lake will do well in the primary. She has a primary opponent. She will do well in the primary here. There's no doubt about that because this is a MAGA base. But it'll be very difficult for her to win over independents and moderate Republicans who are needed to win a general election. And the probably the only thing she has going for her is Ruben Gallego, her likely Democratic opponent, is a fairly liberal. He's a progressive liberal Democrat. And he may be too liberal for a lot of independents and right-leaning Republicans to actually fill in the ballot for. So, you know, it's long ways. 7-8 months till election day. But Carrie Lake is going to have a real hard problem moderating her positions compared to 2022. Her Carrie Lake of 2024, her worst enemy is Carrie Lake from 2 years ago.
Denver, in North Carolina, Trump endorsed Mark Robinson, won the GOP nomination for the governor's race there. Robinson has called LGBTQ people, quote, filth. He has quoted Hitler. He has cast doubt on the Holocaust. And a recent HuffPost report revealed that in 2020, Robinson even said he wanted to turn back time on women's rights.
It's like John Thune endorsing Carrie Lake, you know, and it's like this, you know, crazy cat, North Carolina. It's like Republicans are voting for people that believe that Lord of the Rings is a documentary. You know, and I love the fact that, you know, both of us think, you know, we don't have a home. I think we do. I think at some point you got to make a decision, you know, how you're going to vote, whether it's for this country or it's for insanity. And you would look at Mark, you know, Robinson, you know, look at North Carolina. The fact that he got the votes that he did should shock anybody, you know, with an IQ above moron. But I do believe, you know, as the election gets closer, if Joe Biden were to win, I think it's a couple issues. I think it's Dobbs. I think women are going to come in hard. But I also think it's, you know, people screaming and carrying the rhino flag. I think that might overcome the MAGA flag, right? When you see people that are center right independents or even, you know, I would say people who thought they were Trumpian going into this election cycle. And I also believe those independents and center right who just can't stomach the insanity of Donald Trump or the Carrie Lakes or the Mark Robinsons from North Carolina.
Denver Riggleman, former congressman from Virginia, and Barrett Marson of Arizona, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.
Thanks, Laura.